Hi, I'm Jonathan from Rupert Neve Designs, and today I'm going to show you how to set up and begin using your new 511 500 series microphone preamp. Because the 511 is designed for the 500 series, it requires a separate rack and power supply. We're using the Rupert Neve Designs R6. You will need some cables to begin using your new gear, and depending on the kind of rack and the other gear you're using it with, those will either be DB25, XLR, or quarter inch TRS cables. Today we're going to be using XLR. You want to start by connecting your microphone to the XLR input on the back of the 500 series rack and a separate XLR output that will either feed your interface, a mixer, or another piece of gear. You want to make sure that you're connecting to the right slot and the right input and output on the back of your rack. When you power your rack, you'll see the blue LED on the 511 come on, letting you know you have power. The next thing you're going to want to do is turn on 48 volt phantom power if you have a condenser or an active ribbon. If you have a passive ribbon or a dynamic microphone or a condenser with its own power supply, you won't need to do this and you can leave the 48 volt off. Now it's time for some sound. The first thing that you're going to want to do is turn up the red rotary gain switch about 2/3 or 3/4 of the way. You want to make sure you see all the green LEDs on the level meter and maybe one or two of the yellow. You also want to make sure you're testing a fairly loud portion of the signal so you get the right level. Use the trim for plus or minus 6 dB of fine control. Engage the phase switch if you want to invert the polarity on your microphone. If you want to remove some unwanted low frequencies, for example if you're recording acoustic guitar or vocals, engage the high pass filter and bring it up to approximately 100 Hz. This frequency may vary depending on the type of material you're recording and how much reduction you need. The silk button and texture are very special features of the 511 preamp. They allow you to saturate the output transformer and add mid-range harmonics. This provides the vintage vibe and character Rupert Neve is so well known for. Engage the silk button and turn up the texture knob, and remember, the harder you hit the output of the 511, the more apparent the silk will be. Remember, you can learn about all our gear at rupertneve.com, and feel free to contact us if you have any further questions.